As the parents of a newborn child, one of the scariest things in the world is to be notified that your perfect new baby may have a life-altering disease. And imagine receiving this news in a letter from the state that reads, "The newborn screen referred to above was positive for cystic fibrosis." The newborn screening results are as follows. We know an experience like this can be scary. But one of the most important things you need to know is that the newborn state screening happens to all newborns. And this test screens for over 36 kinds of health conditions, including cystic fibrosis. A screening test is done to a large number of newborns to look for ones who might have a disease. Most babies will be negative. It is important to know that the screening tests are not a diagnosis. So it's best to talk to a Cystic Fibrosis Foundation accredited representative about your child's screening.
Good morning. Mrs. Jones? Hi, this is Katherine Anderson.
I'm a nurse practitioner and part of the state's newborn screening program. How are you doing today?
Fine.
Well, first let me take a minute and congratulate you on your new baby girl, Emily.
Well, thank you.
Did you know that Emily had newborn screening done when she was born? You see, the newborn nursery collected a little bit of blood from Emily's heel and it was sent to the state lab.
So they could look for things Emily might have been born with, which would cause trouble if it wasn't picked up early.
Is Emily okay?
I'm calling to let you know about one of the results. One of the screening tests was for cystic fibrosis.
Do you know what cystic fibrosis is?
No, I don't think so.
Cystic fibrosis, or CF, is a condition a baby is born with which could make it hard for them to gain weight or lead to more lung infections. The CF gene is passed down through generations, just like blue eyes or red hair. You have to have a gene from mom and a gene from dad in order to have cystic fibrosis. People who have just one gene are called carriers, and they don't have any symptoms, and they wouldn't even know that they had a gene for cystic fibrosis. Having a gene for cystic fibrosis is actually pretty common. It's found in all ethnic groups, but most commonly found in Caucasians.
But Emily doesn't have it, does she?
Probably not. Most babies with abnormal newborn screenings don't have cystic fibrosis.
Emily's screening shows that she has one gene for cystic fibrosis, so we want to do a sweat test
to confirm that she does not have CF.
A sweat test?
Well, we know babies with cystic fibrosis have too much salt in their sweat. So a sweat test is a simple test we do where we wrap Emily's arms and collect a little bit of sweat and measure how much salt is in it.
Well, how long will the test take? It won't hurt her, will it?
It takes about an hour. It doesn't hurt, although Emily may feel a little tingling in her arm.
You don't need to do anything special except make sure Emily has plenty to eat so she'll be well hydrated.
Your child's sweat test should be done at a CF Foundation accredited care center, as it must be done by a lab which specializes in collecting and running sweat tests. You can find one of these centers at the Cystic Fibrosis Foundation website. If your baby's sweat test is normal, then your baby does not have CF and is just a carrier for one gene. This will be important for your child to know when they grow up, so keep the newborn screening paperwork with their baby records.
Well, how soon will I get Emily's sweat test results?
Well, sometimes the sweat test results come back the same day, but they're always back within a few days.
Whether you have received a letter, a phone call, or have your child's sweat test results, you're sure to have questions. The Cystic Fibrosis Foundation is a nonprofit organization dedicated to improving care for people with CF. The CFF's website is a valuable resource. You can find answers to questions like, what is CF? How do you treat it? What does this mean for the future? As well as other family resources, informational videos, and publications.
Oh, thank you for calling me. You've really taken a load off my mind.
Once Emily's sweat test is done, just give me a call if you have any questions or concerns.
I will. Thank you. All right, bye.
And remember, even if your child does have CF, you can get through this. You're not alone. The Cystic Fibrosis Foundation and its care centers are here to assist you on your journey.
When your child is born, you're worried about things like
feeding and sleeping.
You haven't even thought about the newborn screening results. You may have never even heard of cystic fibrosis.
If you get a call about your child's newborn screening,
don't panic.
Understand that the chance that your baby has cystic fibrosis is very small. The quickest and most reliable way to prove your baby doesn't have CF
is a sweat test.
Sweat tests are painless and they require no special preparation.
It's important to get the facts, but get them from a reliable source.
To learn more about cystic fibrosis,
contact your local CF care center or go to cff.org
for current, accurate information.
If your child is diagnosed with CF,
you're not alone. Your CF Care Center and the Cystic Fibrosis Foundation is here to help you and your child.